Okay, so we're going to be talking about the Annabelle wrap dress, which is a woven dress. When you get your con sheet, there'll be a call for you to block fuse some of the pattern pieces for this dress, and we're going to take you through the block fusing of these pieces. Okay, so we've got one here, and there's one on the ironing board right now. So we've cut out a piece of fabric and some block fuse, and it's slightly bigger than the pattern piece that we are going to use to cut it out. So we've got the right side facing down on the ironing board, and then the fuse to the back. There's a lot of different fuse types that you use when you fuse fabrics. Because this is a lightweight woven crepe, you've got to be careful that you're not using very heavy fuse, because that will ruin the look of the dress. So it's got to be quite light to match the fabric so it has a bit of flow. So you turn it over once you've given it a press with a hot iron, not too hot though. And almost burnt out. So we pin the piece together, put it over here, and we'll cut that out in a minute. Grab your second piece. Oh, we can do that? No, we won't do that. We'll cut that out. Okay, so you're pinning the piece down. Take your sharp fabric scissors and cut. Nice nails.
Thank you.
Okay, so Lynn's a speedy Gonzales with the scissors. If I was cutting this, I'd take twice the amount of time. Did you see how she just cut in where the notch marks are with the scissors? Just that will help you match your pattern pieces correctly when you come to sew it. So make sure you don't miss any of those. They should all match up perfectly. That's that. Pins out. And there you go. That's the back neck facing. And then
necessarily
draw. Yeah, I won't go through. And so you repeat that process for all the pattern pieces that are marked main and fuse. Okay? So exact same process that you just saw there. Okay. Okay, so on our table we have the cut pattern pieces of our Annabelle dress. It's going to be a little bit tricky if I don't stand on the table for you to see all the pieces, so I'll just walk you through each of them. So so here we have the front skirt, and it's cut one pair main. So just to let you know, right side is on the inside here of the fabric, and then we've got some pieces that have been cut on the fold, like this piece here. So this is the back skirt that's been cut on the fold, so the right side is on the inside. We've got the back bodice cut on the fold as well, and we've got another pair of the front bodice cut as a pair. We've got our fused pieces, which I spoke about a little earlier, which we've fused already. And then down here we've got our ties and our neck frill and our sleeve frill. So we did a little video earlier on that for our mock-up, but we'll go into that in greater detail very soon. So it's a good idea, once you've cut all your pattern pieces out, just to lay them out like we have here, and then you can sort of see how the dress goes together. So skirt and bodice, and then you've got the back bodice, and then the back skirt. So yep, just to try to keep it clear in your mind, that's a good way to lay out your pattern pieces. Okay, so that's the dart. Do you want to flip it over and we'll have a look at the other side? Great. Right. So this is the back bodice, isn't it?
Yes. There's your dot.
So mark that.
Dot.
And there's got the two notch marks. Yep. Pinch them together.
Back stitch. Hold it firm.
Yep.
Gradually run off towards.
How much would you be running past that chalk mark?
Probably a centimetre.
1 centimetre. Next step is to, what was it?
Join the back to the front, join the shoulder seam.
Excellent. seam allowance on this
centimetre.
1 centimetre. Here Cheryl's got the wearer's right, and you're going to sew down to where the first notch mark is, and you're going to leave a little hole, is that right?
Yes.
For the tie to be threaded through.
Yeah.
Okay.
Here we go.
So only on the wearer's right will you have this little hole, the wearer's left will be sewn all the way through. It's with a wrap.
Back stitch,
yep.
And then do the same at the bottom, at the next knit.
Great, just finish that off. So the wearer's left will have no hole, just the wearer's right.
Nice and clean. So you ignore the nicks.
Oh, that's right, because they would be nicked from
the
game. Yes, got it.
Up on the double.
Okay, so.
Make sure the dart's pointing down.
Oh, that's a good point.
And then you can overlock.
Fabulous.
Okay.
So anyone that might have missed that, the dart, sew it, press, pull it down as you stitch over it.
Okay,
so then you take your bodice. So you take your bodice over to your overlocker, and what are you going to do first?
I overlock on the right hand side where the hole is open.
Oh, I can't really see that. That's alright.
Little pass.
Right.
And then I come down from the armhole so that I'm leaving that little opening free.
Oh, okay. I don't know if I can see it that well. And you pull it off. Then if you can open it up.
See, you've still got the little hole.
Okay, so you did this side.
One side first, a little bit, and then you come down from the armhole.
Right.
And finish it off. Okay.
Fabulous. So you're doing the other side, the wearer's left, is that right?
Yep. Up from the bottom, across the shoulder.
It's continuous. And you cut it. So fast. Oh, clever.
There we go.
Professional. There we go. We'll lay it flat so we can have a look. Okay, so that's the wearer's left.
And the wearer's
right.
The wearer's right
with the little hole. And then the shoulders.
Okay,
onto the skirt.
Okay, here we have the skirt, which we join the side seams, matching the notches.
Mm-hmm. Centimetre seam.
Stretch the fabric a little,
mm-hmm.
so the seam doesn't crack.
Okay.
Just a little
tension.
Yeah.
Would you do the same for a knit, just for curiosity?
Yes.
Same amount of tension.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And then repeat on the other side. Okay. Might see that step.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, Cheryl's just finishing off the other side seam of the skirt. We forgot to mention that right sides together with the fabric for the skirt. I'm sure you guys probably know that, but if there's a newbie sewer out there, yes, the right sides are together when you're sewing down the side.
So now we overlock.
So over to the overlocker. Then once the side seams are overlocked, then we'll join the skirt to the bodice. So, zom, zom, zom. Cutting off when you're
just any hairy bits.
Not much. Okay, so skirts complete, bodice is complete. Go over and match them up. Okay, so what's the next step? This is quite important, isn't it?
It's making the holes secure. So we just stitch around it by 1/4 inch or across. And down. So that's it.
Oh, nice. Very nice. Scribbly bits.
Yep.
And then you're matching the skirt to the bodice, aren't you?
Yes.
Right.
So any nicks and the seams, pin through.
Yes.
And then put it, match it. So you've got.
Sorry, so you're pinning where the notch marks are?
Yeah.
To
where have we got one?
Okay.
So centimetre seam again?
Yes.
Back stitch.
And so where are you starting?
From the front.
From the front.
Okay. Left hand side.
Okay. Right sides together?
Yes.
Yep. Where is left, is it? Sorry.
Yes.
That's the wrap, I can see it now.
Sorry.
Make sure that notches and gives some tension.
Mm-hmm. Good idea so that the stitching doesn't crack if you've pulled it tight.
Why is that?
Just if anything, see, it's got a little bit of stretch in it. It's
okay,
just
the fabric.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Because it's quite soft.
Okay. Did you just grab that pin there?
Yeah. I backstitch over the seams.
Okay, why do you backstitch?
Just to secure it.
Give it a bit more stability.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
We turn our darts to the centre back.
Oh, okay. You hear that, everyone? Darts to the centre back and stitch over.
Bodice joined to the skirt. We've overlocked the skirt. Now we're going to overlock the bodice.
Oh, so sorry, matching the yes. You're going to guys. My phone had a malfunction. So over at the machine, Cheryl joined the bodice to the skirt, and yes, it needs to be overlocked now. Anything special to know about this, Cheryl?
Nothing.
No. So just a simple overlock. I think you did mention when you were sewing the bodice and the skirt together about the tension again.
Yeah.
Just to make sure you had tension because that fabric is particularly bouncy, is that right?
Yeah. It's very... Just neaten it off. all the hairy bits and the threads. Makes it all neat. Then we move on to putting the ties on.
Now we make the tie that goes into the waist on the fate.
So I didn't really see that. So you've just got...
Just fold the quarter centimetre in, mm-hmm. fold it over, and...
So you've got... you're folding it in on itself, so the wrong side of the fabric's on the inside. Yep. You halve that and then halve it again.
Mm-hmm. And then you That's fold better. It to the centre.
Right.
Just make sure it's even.
Half and then fold it in on itself again.
Just run your finger down the middle and it'll straighten out.
Mm-hmm. Do you need to give tension to the back, or it's just heavy as much as the front?
Yeah.
Yep.
It's pretty solid. It's cut on the other grain.
On the cross grain?
Yep. It up at the bottom,
mm-hmm.
and then you fold it in so you've got a neat edge.
Yep.
It's a hairy fabric.
And then what do you do with it to the end?
You just poke it in.
Right.
Turn it round, stitch across.
Oh, very nice.
And then you stitch up on the fold side.
Nice. You make that look so easy.
It's like a little snake. It's just a matter of guiding it through. The machine does it all.
Great.
Now, we put that rough end, place it at the waist, the seam up.
Okay, sorry, I'll go just get that clear. So you've taken the poor end of the tie.
Yep, place it.
And that is, you're stitching that
on the end of the bodice where it wraps.
Got it.
And the other one, you do the same. I'll find it. There it is. Okay. So you take the rough end,
mm-hmm.
put the seam down, and put it on the end. So then you just lay it on and stitch it. So then...
The seams are together, you can
have
it. Okay. That's pretty
clear. Just trim it away. Then you sew, get your facings out and stitch them together.
Okay, so you said you've grabbed all your facings.
So yep. You've got the back neck facing, the front facing for the wrap, and the skirt facing. There's an angle.
You pin them together.
Yeah. So you put them and use a centimetre seam to join them with. You repeat that, join your neck facing to the front, sure it lines up with the neck edge. See, you've got
your wrap edge, and now you join the skirt face. Which is on an angle.
Why is it on an angle?
Because it's you've got your bodice is on an angle.
Of course.
Okay, so we've done that.
Yeah, so the facing goes down the wrap.
So we overlock the edge. We overlock the outside edge.
Mm-hmm.
Oops,
caught it.
Good catch. Which is?
Is this the back neck facing?
This is
overlock?
Skirt facing.
Skirt facing.
We go up the outside edge.
And how do you just know which is the outside edge?
Because this is a neck edge,
yes.
And that's where it goes, joins onto the skirt.
Right.
There's a neck
mm-hmm.
that matches up.
Right.
Turn your shoulder seam to the back.
Mm-hmm.
Makes it neat.
Attaching the facing to the dress now.
Yep. Start at the hem.
So oh, okay.
There's a matching neck.
Okay, that's important.
Yep.
So you can play around with this until you've got it right.
Okay.
So you start at the hem?
Yes. Centimeter seam?
Yes.
Not supposed to run over pins, but I do.
Yeah, that was very you can daring
do
before. I was thinking that was a bit dangerous, but I picked up the phone. I was going to say, when you're a professional like yourself, you can run over pins.
Keep your tie out of the way. Come up to the point.
Mm-hmm. So your tie's under there, isn't
yes.
it?
Yes. Mm. You put your needle down, take the pin out, and swivel.
Oh, okay, because you're turning the corner.
Yep. Yeah.
Got that.
So
now you're going up the front wrap, aren't you?
Yes.
Right. Do you need to backstitch there or not?
No.
Not really, no.
Find your shoulder. Make sure there.
Bring them together. Make it look so easy.
Make sure it's not stretching because there is a neck there that you'd match up.
Okay, so you just don't want to stretch one side over the
no.
other, right? So work from neck to neck.
Yep. One side will look bigger, but it's not. It's just stretched a little. So just ease it back.
Okay.
Is
the iron beeping at me behind? Okay, whoop. Get out. So you got the other wrap? Yes.
Match the nicks?
Yes. This is the open one.
Always stop when you leave your needle down, it saves movement.
Good to know.
So match up your shoulder seams.
Yes.
And make sure it's flat.
So your needle's down so it's not moving.
Yep.
And your seams are toward
the back.
Stitching them to the back, that's right.
So you've got your tie in there.
Mm-hmm.
Pin your just find your nick.
Mm-hmm.
And stitch. Make sure it's flat.
So providing the niches are
matched. It will look bigger.
On one side, yes.
Yeah, but it'll go back in because it's cut on the cross.
Yes.
It'll sit flat.
So as long as you're keeping the nicks together as you go,
yes.
You won't really run into too many problems. Is that fair to say?
That's right. Down to the seam.
Mm-hmm.
Put your needle down and swivel.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So now you're going up to the other side of the wrap, to the neck, right?
No. Like down the center front.
Center front. Oh, skirt. Sorry.
Skirt. Should match up with the knicks, and it does. Such good patterns.
Previous experience.
This way.
Beautiful!
Back stitch there.
Mm-hmm.
You come back and you can trim this away.
Yes. Reduce the bulk, right?
Yes.
Yes.
Come up here,
right.
And you can nick in at the neck. So when you open it out, it sits flatter.
Don't hey, go, that's a good tip.
Don't go all the way through.
Through your stitch. So is it just so each side of the wrap around the neck?
Mm-hmm. So
okay.
It'll be like that. So you got it in the point. So now,
when you snipped across the
neckline.
Sorry, what did you say?
When you turn it back, it goes out.
Oh, okay.
So it's not too tight. See,
okay.
It opens up.
Yes, sorry. Yep, got it.
Now we start with top back stitch.
Okay.
Or flat stitch.
Okay, I think I'm going to stop and I'm
going to
start.
Facing?
Yes.
Skirt?
Yes.
And you open it up and you push the seam to the facing. And then you flat stitch on the edge so that you get a nice crisp fold. So you continue that all the way around.
I'm not going to film all of this,
that
will take forever, but I'll just show them your stitch. So this is the facing here. She's turned the seam, is that right?
Yep,
to the facing side, and she's flat stitching along the. So neat. Okay. Okay, so we will go through this on the other side, but this is the turned out facing, which is quite an important step for those that haven't really done it before. So we'll take you through that. So it's been edge stitched, the facing, yep. And it's nice just to keep your project or your sewing neat as you go.
Under press.
So it's, getting an under press. And this is this lovely tie which it was nipped in there. Pressing the seams up. So that waist seam is pressed up as well. Okay. Important shoulder seam, press it to the back. Back neck facing. Snap down. Okay, we might move over to the sleeve, I think. Cheryl has completed one sleeve, but we'll take you through the next one. How cute is that with that ruffle?
Needs a press.
Yeah, flat it out. Thank you. Okay, we'll move on to the sleeve.
So I will neaten both sides of the frill.
Okay,
I've already done one, so
neaten is, I don't know if it's a universal term, when you double turn it. It's very fine.
Yes, so you turn it over twice.
Mm-hmm.
Start off slowly.
The conversion is, and it'll be 5 mils.
Probably, yeah. Just push all the wayward threads under, and
second side of the ruffle.
Yeah.
I guess if people don't want to double turn it or neaten it, they could just baby lock it, couldn't they?
Yes.
If they like that look. I guess it just really depends on what you want to give a go or what the look that you're after. Okay.
Nearly finished.
Is the width the same for the sleeve ruffle to the front?
Yes.
Yes. So you'll have lots of practice once you've done them all.
Turn my stitch to a biggest one and I run down the middle.
So wait. So this is to create the ruffle,
yes.
Correct?
Yes.
So your right side facing up.
Yep.
And a big stitch. How big?
Oh, well, I've just gone to the biggest.
Okay.
So got a gathering foot, you can use that. Just leave a tail so you can pull it and repeat.
Starting the same side?
Yes. Just run it parallel to the other row.
So not on top?
No.
Just be closer than that. You're going to pull the two together, right?
Yes. So you separate the threads and pull the loosest one, which is the back.
So when you say separate, so
well, you've got two, this is the back and the front.
Wrong side of the fabric, yep. So you find the two, yes?
Yep, and so you find it and you just slide it up so that it is the length of your sleeve hem.
Oh, okay, that's important.
So,
so if one side's more gathered than the other, so you just feed it through until it's evenly spaced, right?
So you just open it up, space it out, make it more even.
Yes.
As long as you've got should be right. Now, I overlock the bottom of the hem.
Oops, nearly fell off. The hem of the sleeve. Okay.
Yep.
So that's where the ruffle is going to be attached.
Try not to cut anything off. We press it up.
This is the wrong side facing up, and then you're turning it back.
Yep. Be careful you don't burn yourself.
Yeah. Okay, so right side is under me. Creating like a little hem.
Okay.
It's an overlocked part.
Mm-hmm.
Back to the machine.
So you've got right side up.
Okay, let's right side up.
Centre. Pin it to the centre.
So you don't press the ruffle at this stage?
No.
No.
Press it so that you catch the hem as you sew.
Okay, that makes sense.
And just space it out so that it fits on. Gotta untwist it.
So you don't bother pinning it all the way through?
No. Well, you can if you want to. But...
So you open up the ruffle.
Yep.
And then you stitch through the centre.
Yep. Stitching your hem up as you go.
Oh, right. Yes.
You might get to take the stitch back to what you normally sew.
Mm-hmm.
Threads out of the way. Leave it a little bit flat under the arm. You don't want a big frill.
Oh, that's a good point. So gradually.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you go through the middle of the two rows.
Mm-hmm. Where you thread,
yeah.
Pull the thread.
Just keep it flattish. This to the end.
I might, when you get through a little bit, I might just turn the back of the sleeve over just to show you how you've caught.
Mm-hmm.
Or to look at that hem that you've turned up the overlocked.
Okay.
This is a delicate part.
Mm-hmm. Just to even it out as you go along.
Yes.
I'll turn it over and you can see
beautiful.
The back.
Oh, beautiful. Okay. So, yes. So you've got that. Beautiful. Okay, I'll stop there. So,
so
that's completed.
Yeah. So
it's really cute.
Then
like a little hat.
Then you sew the ends together. Keep the seam down. Match up yours. Back stitch, a centimetre seam.
Mm-hmm. Right sides together.
Yep. And then you overlock the seam.
Right.
Okay, so we just trim off the hairs. Done. Okay, so you overlock the thing down to the bottom.
Am I using the hand wheel?
Because I'm just doing it slowly.
Okay.
You put your needle down.
Yes.
And flip it back.
Okay.
So you've got a nice neat edge at the bottom of the...
I might pull it out. Have a look.
See?
Oh,
okay. No threads.
It's very deep. That
line's
doing something funny. Okay.
So there you go.
Show me the inside, please. The right side. Yes, we're on the home stretch.
Gather across the top.
Okay, so you've gathered that one.
Yep.
Yes. So is it to... How do you know what to gather
well,
to?
Got
notch
your,
marks?
You've got
Nick's
oops, sorry, notch Nick. Marks that match Nick. Up on the sleeve here.
Right.
So this is the left sleeve.
Okay, so if I
left armhole, grab that, match up your underarm, turn the seam to the back. Okay, so keep your frill out of the way. So bring it up so that the neck in the top, just seam to the back. Okay. So push your frill down. Seam to the back. Yes, yep. It's not a very big seam because I need a little sleeve.
Okay. Tricky. Any tricks for this?
No.
Left, right?
Yeah, well, so your nicks will match up with the nicks on the sleeve.
Okay.
You can pull the gathering stitch out after you finish. I use my unpicker to make sure it's evenly gathered. Getting dark. This shoulder seam.
Go.
Facing the shoulder seam, so I put them together and turn it over and just catch it along the seam a little bit, so the facing stays stitched.
Oh, so it doesn't fold out. Yes.
Just trim any bits off. And do repeat that to the other side.
And do you catch it by hand, like down through the skirt?
You don't have to. It should stay back.
Yeah.
Well, you can if you want to. Secure.
Beautiful.
Okay.
What's the next step?
So you make sure the facing is flat.
Okay.
So it's not pulling. So you take the facing, turn it back on itself.
Yes.
The hem will be 2 centimeters. So you start there. This is called bagging out. Back stitch.
End of the skirt, yeah.
So turn it through and the nice clean edge.
Okay, do you do an edge stitch there or just press it?
No, we'll have to overlock the hem and sew that up. So I'll do the hem now.
Okay, so you already did the other side, did you?
Yep.
Okay. It is getting dark in here.
Turn it out. So you turn it back,
open it up,
start at the end and go all the way along the hem.
And the skirt, the skirt.
Turn the seam to the back.
Yep, the side seam.
Yep.
Yep, seam to the back. So like the darts really, so they're all uniformed.
It's a little bit wobbly, just straighten it up a little. Too much.
That's facing to the back.
Yep.
So are you meaning the cut of the pattern? Cut the cut.
There you go. Whoop.
Okay. Love it when you do that. Right.
You turn it back.
Yes.
And then we can stitch along the hemline. Start from here.
Just cut.
Yeah, sorry. So it's nice and neat.
Beautiful. That looks lovely.
Okay, any threads off?
Yes.
Pull it through. Pull out the point.
Yes. It's late in the day here and I've exchanged my heels for my slippers. How's that? Alright, okay, let's do the hem.
Start at the facing.
Mm-hmm.
Back stitch a little. And just fold it up 2 centimetres and stitch on the very edge. Try not to twist it.
Oh, is that like roping when...
Yeah. See?
Yes, yes. Usually roping can happen when the hem's really narrow, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You can hold this a little bit.
Yes.
So, because your lower hem will be bigger than your skirt. Just match up the seam.
Sorry, what was that? The lower
hem on the edge will be bigger than this bit.
Yes.
So if you hold that a little bit firmer
and
match up your seams, you might not get the roping. So you just hold a bit.
Yes.
Leave your needle down when you stop. A bit of fusing on the face. Okay. Stitch a little. May we have it? Trim away any threads. The neck frill has a join. It's centre back.
Yes.
So I've already done one side, so I'll continue doing on the other side. The same as we did for the sleeve.
Okay.
Turn it over twice.
Double turn, very narrow one. Oh, so it's exactly the same process as the sleeve ruffle, so I don't think I'll feel more of this.
Okay, that's fine.
So it's double turned, then you're going to run 2 stitch lines
through the middle,
parallel next to each other through the middle. But maybe I'll come back and feel that it, because it's an extra long piece, it's not probably going to be the same way where you pull it through, right?
No.
Okay, so I'll come back and we'll see how she'll... creates the ruffle on a really long piece that's joined.
Okay, so did can we just look at maybe the ruffle?
So you did the 2 stitches and did you stop it halfway when we did the mock-up?
Yes.
So because it's extra long.
Yes. So and you finished the ends off.
Okay, so you double turned them
and
then stitched them over. Oops, actually I think I was looking at it, not filming.
So you finish the ends off.
Yes.
And then you gather it up.
Okay. Of the ruffle.
Oh,
where you join the two.
Yeah.
And you find the wearer's left shoulder seam. So when you stitched up the ruffle, was it 2 continuous stitches all the way through?
Yeah.
Or did you stop it halfway and then use that to pull and then...
This one I didn't.
Oh, so you just did it all the way through. And does that ever create a problem where it breaks, or is it tricky to pull such a long piece of thread considering they're just 2 stitches?
Well, I only go from halfway.
Okay.
So
what do you mean by that?
Well, I only pull it from
here. Oh, okay. And then you work it through.
Yeah.
So you're attaching.
Make sure you don't twist it.
You take the ruffle seam and you put it to the wearer's left shoulder seam.
Even it out a bit.
Yes.
So you can still pull it up while it's on the
stitch, yes.
Okay, so pin it down.
So this would you think this is the most fiddly part of the dress?
Yes.
Because you don't want it to sort of look really ruffly in one part and vacant that's in another. Is that
that's
right?
True.
Yeah. So she's pinned it to the front of the wrap and then at the centre back. Then Cheryl's just trying to get an even spread of the ruffle, I guess.
Yes.
And make sure it's not twisted.
Yeah.
Before you start sewing it.
So, and it just sits in about a centimetre from the edge.
Oh, yes.
Can you turn
it's
that?
Not your head. Oh, what's that? So there's a notch in the pattern, isn't there?
Yes.
You've just marked it. Oops. Oh my gosh, I'm looking and not filming properly. Okay, so starting then. So you're starting the ruffle there.
On the left-hand side.
The wearer's left-hand wrap because you don't want that bulk underneath the wrap. So it doesn't wrap, the ruffle doesn't start here because you've got the other wrap coming across.
So just push it evenly across, which takes a little while.
So you've sort of ruffled it up a bit, haven't you?
Yeah.
And then you've pinned it into place and then you're going to get the look right.
Yes.
And make sure
it's even.
It's not twisting either.
Yeah.
So that's a bit of a fiddly thing. So
I'll just start off.
Okay.
And then I'll show you the finished. So it's about half a centimetre down from the edge. Sort of.
This is really fiddly. So I guess, do you pin it at the other end? Or?
Yes, I have.
Oh, you're just getting it going, are you?
Yeah. So it'll end up looking.
That stitch line, is that going in between the stitches that you've pulled to
yes.
ruffle it?
Yes, yep. Which is hard to see, but...
Yep. It's getting dark, so.
Yeah, alright.
Quite a slow process. I probably won't film all of that. I guess.
When then we're nearly finished. Once the frill's on.
Right.
Okay. We'll show you the finished product.
Okay. Okay, so here is Annabelle. This is our final sample and she looks lovely. We have made a couple of changes to this final pattern. So you can see that tie looks a little bit short. We've added 10 centimetres length to both both tie sides, so that will be ample. We tried to economize with the ruffle by putting a seam in it, but if you have plenty of fabric, you don't need to do that. You can just cut one continuous piece. And so that's the final product, which is quite nice actually. This fabric's lovely. Okay, so hope you've enjoyed this tutorial and we'll try to do some more soon.